Hello everyone, greeting to all of you. Last lecture we discussed the introduction of public health engineering. So now we will see the chapter 1, that is sources, quantity and quality of water. Content of this chapter is sources of water, quantity of water and quality of water. So first we will see the sources of water. There are various sources of water, but all these sources are mainly depending on rain. Water which comes from rain is 100% pure and fresh water. On the basis of storage, sources are divided into two categories, that is surface source and subsurface source of water. So we will see what is surface source of water. When the surface runoff obtained from the rainwater get accumulate into the natural water bodies such as river, lake, ponds, streams, etc. and man-made water bodies like reservoir, dams, etc. then it is called as surface water or surface of water. Surface means above the ground. So the surface source means the water which stores on or above the ground, that source is called as surface source of water. There are various types of surface source, which are river, lake, streams, storage reservoir and ponds. You all know and also see all these sources. And then first we will see what is river. River, when number of streams comes together or combined together, then resulting combined stream is called as river. It is most important source of water used for public water supply schemes. Okay, then second one is lake. Lakes are natural large size depressions or natural large size basins formed within the surface of earth and filled with rainwater is known as lake. Then third one is streams. When a small amount of water flowing down the hills or mountainous area, then it is called as streams. The quantity of water available in streams are mostly in rainy season. Later on after monsoon, they may go dry. Then next one is storage reservoir. It is the man-made basin. It is formed by constructing the dams at an appropriate size across the river valley, where the amount of runoff is more. And the last surface source is ponds. Ponds are natural small size inland depressions filled with rainwater. So these are all the types of surface source. Then next we will see subsurface source. So first we see what is subsurface source. When the water get percolated into ground, then brought to the surface for the use, it is called as subsurface source. It is also called as underground water source. Subsurface means below the ground level. Okay, a portion of rainfall infiltrate in the ground and gets stored as subsurface water at hard murum. That is, when rain is fall, some portion of the water infiltrate into the ground and stored as a subsurface of water. Then these are the types of subsurface source: infiltration well, infiltration gallery and springs. So first we see what is infiltration wells. The wells are sunk in series in sandy riverbeds for tapping water from sandy riverbeds is called as infiltration well. This type of well are constructed in brick masonry work with open joints. The top of the wells are covered with RCC slab, that is reinforced cement concrete slab, having manhole for inspection. Then second type of subsurface is well. So we will see types of well. There are two types of well, that is shallow well and second one is deep well. First we see what is shallow well. When the well which rest in the top water bearing strata and draw their supplies from the surrounding material, then it is called as shallow well. This type of well depends upon the depth of wall. The diameter of the shallow well usually vary from 1 meter to 10 meter, and the depth of this well are not very deep. Then the second type of well is deep well. A deep well is a well raised on impervious layer and draw their supplies from the pervious formation laying below the impervious layer is called as deep well. It is a type of open well having depth ranging from 2 meter to 20 meter. These walls are generally constructed by digging, hence it is also called as dug well. Then the third type of subsurface is infiltration gallery. In order to tap the water from sandy river beds, it is more convenient to construct a horizontal tunnel into a river bed at a shallow depth of about 3 meter to 5 meter along the bank of the river is called as infiltration gallery. These galleries are constructed to store the underground water. Then the next type of subsurface is springs. When there is a natural outflow of groundwater coming at the surface of earth, then it is called as springs. That is, when groundwater table is high, then water is come on the ground in the form of springs. So these are the all types of subsurface source. Next we will see intake structure. Intake means go inside. What is intake structure? Water goes inside of intake from the resources like river, lake, and then this water from intake structures goes to the water treatment plant. These are masonry or concrete structures. This is a definition of intake structure. It is the structure constructed across the surface of water in order to withdrawal of water from the water sources is called as intake structure. So these are the functions of intake structures. First function is intake structure collect the water from surface source, and the second function is it discharges the collected water from the surface source into the water purification plant or water treatment plant. Then the types of intake structure. There are three types of intake structures, that is river intake, canal intake, and reservoir intake or lake intake. Now we will see one by one in brief. First we will see what is river intake. The definition of river intake is it is a circular well having diameter of 3 meter to 7 meter constructed on the bank of river. It can be constructed in masonry work or concrete work. These are the some points of river intake. First point is, it is a circular masonry tower along with 4 meter to 7 meter diameter. And second one is, it is constructed along the river bank at a place from where water can be drawn in required quantity. This is a diagram of river intake. From this diagram, you can see there are two levels, HFL and LWL. HFL means high flood level and LWL means low water level. Water from river goes under the river intake by the penstocks with screens. Then pumps are used. These are the pumps. Pumps are used to raise the water to the rising main, and from rising main water goes to the water treatment plant. Then sump well is used to collect the sump or to collect the dirt. Then penstocks are usually fitted with the screens so as to collect the entry of the floating solid material. Okay, so from this diagram you can see all the component part of the river intake. Then next type of intake structure is canal intake. So first we will see definition of canal intake. What is canal intake? The intake structure when constructed on the bank of canal, then it is called as canal intake. These are the some points of canal intake. Water get entered into the intake chamber through the coarse grain. Then second is a pipe is provided with a bell mouth shaped inlet placed in the chamber. The water level is almost constant throughout the year and sluice valve also provided to control the flow of water. And the last point is the chamber is built in brick masonry work partially in the canal and partially in RCC wall of the bank of the canal. So we will see the diagram of canal intake. This is canal intake. From this diagram you can see there is also two levels, FSL and LWL. FSL means full supply level and LWL means low water level. This structure is constructed on the bank of canal and the water of the canal flows to the canal intake. The FSL and LWL means full supply level and low water level. You can see this screen. You can see the there is a screen, coarse screen. This screen is provided to remove the dust from water. Then on the canal intake, valve is also provided to manage the water level of outlet. Then the mouth of outlet, the shape of outlet mouth is bell shape or perforated screen, is provided to remove the fine particle. There is only one outlet is provided, this is. There is only one outlet is provided because the level of water is not changes in the canal. Canal has constant water level, hence only one outlet is provided. The next type of intake structure is reservoir level. The structure built near the lake or dam is called as reservoir intake. These are the some points of reservoir intake. First point is the intake pipes are located at different level with a common vertical pipe. There is a valve room from where valves of intake pipes can be operated. Then when the valves of intake pipes are open, then water is discharged from the reservoir through the common vertical pipes. All the intake pipes are provided with screens so as to avoid the entry of any floating solid material. This is the diagram of reservoir intake. This intake has three intake pipes. The first one is second and third. Because the water level in the reservoir changes gradually. At valve room, this is valve room. Okay. At valve room or control room, valves are provided to control the flow of water in the intake pipe. Then it is a concrete wall which can be constructed for reservoir intake. Then this is a foot bridge which is used for go to the control room to control the wall. Then this is a intake well. Intake well is constructed to the intake water. Then outlet pipe. From outlet pipe, the water from the reservoir intake go to the water treatment plant. Then these are the factors governing the location of an intake structure. First factor is there should not be heavy current of water. If there is heavy current of water, we cannot provide intake structure. Then second one is structure should be easily approachable. It should be easily approachable to any person. Then third one is structure should draw sufficient amount of water. It should draw sufficient amount of water. Then next one is intake structure should be near to the water treatment plant. Location of the reservoir near to the water treatment plant. And the last one is site should be easily accessible during flood. If it get flooded, then also we can approach this site. Okay, so these are the governing factors for the location of an intake structure. Okay, up to this, if anybody have any question or problem, then please ask me and complete all assignments which are allotted within time. Okay, thank you.